this is your problem. Final Cut crashes when you try to open a particular library. Well, here's the fix. And a warning, this is not a procedure if you're a novice. It involves opening the protected Final Cut Pro library bundle. So get an experienced person to do it for you if you're unsure. I'm happy to help. Just click training.finalcutpro.com. Otherwise, if you follow the steps in order, you can't get it wrong. Make sure Final Cut's not running. Find the Final Cut library bundle in the Finder. Right-click on the purple icon. That's not the words. Duplicate. You'll see a copy below. Right-click the purple icon. That's not the words. On the original library. Select Show Package Contents. Now move the file that's CurrentVersion.flexolibrary to the trash. Close the package contents file. Now double-click the purple icon on the original library. And first, if Final Cut launches, the problem's fixed, but you need to verify and repair all the projects in the library. I'll show you that later in the tutorial, and you'll find a timestamp that takes you there in the description below. And number two, if Final Cut didn't launch, would you double-click the original library after trashing? Be aware, with this method, you'll lose at least one project. Unlikely more, but it is possible. If you've only got one project in your library, then there's no point in going any further because it won't be recovered with this method. If you want to recover the other projects, then this is what you need to do. Right-click on the original library in the Finder again, Show Package Contents. And you're going to remove each project within each event folder until you get Final Cut to launch. So you'll be removing projects in the event folders one by one until you find the faulty project. Whatever you do, do not remove underscore temp or motion templates folders. Projects are in the event folders, and there can be more than one project in any event folder. These are projects within the event folder, but how do you know? I'll show you in a minute, but first you need to sort out which are the event folders. And you'll know it's an event folder because it contains a file called CurrentVersion.fcpevent. If you've got a lot of events and other folders showing, I suggest you work through and find all the events and then color those folders. Right-click and select a color. I'm using red in this case. To make things hard, the projects that you're going to remove are also folders within those event folders. So now you need to find out what are the project folders. And they will not be called analysis files, original media, render files, shared items, or transcoded media. And when you open what you think is a project folder, it'll have a file called currentversion.fcpevent. And before you ask, yes, that's the same file name as in the open event folder. Same name, but different contents. Don't mix them up. I suggest you color the project folders with another color so you can recognize them later. I'm using green in this case. Now delete projects one at a time until Final Cut launches. And if you think you know which project may be the damaged one, well, try that one first. So you can compare the difference, I'll show you now the projects as they are currently in Final Cut. This is how to do it. Delete the currentversion.flexolibrary file in the library folder. This will be stored in the trash, so you can replace it later if needed. Delete the first project file, Yacht Races 1 in this case. Click on the top back chevron. Double-click the library icon. If Final Cut launches, you've found the damaged project. If it doesn't launch though, you need to replace, that's put back, the folder you removed and the CurrentVersion.flexolibrary file. And how to do that? Well, right click on the original library and show package contents again. Press Command plus C until you see the CurrentVersion.flexolibrary file and the Yacht Races 1 project folder. You could also use the put back command by right clicking on the trash. I suggest you color the project that you've tried with a different color, so yellow in this case. Continue until Final Cut Pro launches. Now that you've got the library to launch, you need to verify and repair all projects to make sure they're okay. And this is the simple bit. Select Smart Collections, Projects. Double-click a project to make sure it's open in the timeline. Hold the Option key and select the Clip menu. You'll see a new command that wasn't visible before you had the Option key down, Verify and Repair Project. If all's okay, you'll get a message, no repair is needed at this time. Otherwise, Final Cut Pro will try to repair the inconsistencies for you. Continue until you've verified all the projects. With this method, there'll be one project that can't be recovered. That's because you've removed it. But all the others will be available to you. And if you haven't done so already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell.